My name is Christine Ruana, and I'm here today to talk to you about all the improvements we've been making to the Visual Studio administrator experience. Over the last several decades, Visual Studio has provided world-class productivity tools for developers. We've also realized how important it is to provide the same level of functionality and support to IT administrators. Those people who have the important responsibility for maintaining their organization's software infrastructure and keeping it secure. The developer tools that we provide to you must be easy to update and easy to manage so that your organization can be resilient to security threats. We want you to always have the most current and best defenses at your disposal. In this talk, I'll be describing the recent improvements we've made to help administrators deploy and manage Visual Studio. As many of you are aware, Visual Studio has a concept of servicing baselines, which are distinct feature version levels that are supported and that enterprises can park on. We're now referring to servicing baselines as long-term servicing channels, or LTSCs. LTSCs provide flexibility and control for when you accept and deploy feature or security updates across your organization. With Visual Studio 2022, there are a few significant improvements I'd like to call your attention to regarding LTSCs. We are now declaring in advance when these additional LTSCs will become available and how long they'll be supported for. Starting with Visual Studio 2022, every 6 months, in the fall and in the spring, we will release a new LTSC that supports the SKUs that our enterprise and professional customers use. Each LTSC release will be supported and kept secure for 18 months. Having better visibility into our upcoming release schedule will hopefully be helpful to you as you plan your upcoming business upgrade cycles. Additionally, these LTSCs now completely behave as independently installable products, which means that it's easier to receive the correct notifications and updates. The second improvement I'd like to highlight here in this talk is an even more fundamental change to the product. In fact, I'm going to demo this because it's so cool. With Visual Studio 2022, you can now configure where your clients are going to get their updates from. We call these update channels. Furthermore, you can also configure what update channels are available to your organization. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Here on this machine, I've installed the Visual Studio 2022 product, and I have the Visual Studio 2022 installer opened. The Visual Studio installer is actually a completely separate app from the main Visual Studio IDE. The installer manages all of the instances that I have installed on the machine, including previous versions. You can see here that I happen to have both Visual Studio 2022 and an older version of Visual Studio 2019 installed. The new installer that comes with Visual Studio 2022 now has the capability of configuring the update channels, or where each one of these Visual Studio products should get its future updates from. When I click on the More button, there's now an option to display the Update Settings dialog, which allows me to configure the update channel. You can see here that this instance of the product is configured to get updates from the Visual Studio 2022 current channel, which contains the latest product hosted by Microsoft. I have the option to switch to either the 17.0 LTSC baseline channel or the preview channel. If I choose the LTSC channel, then all of my subsequent updates and notifications will be sourced from the latest release that is available on that LTSE channel. Oh, one more thing. Don't forget to actually do the update after you change a channel. Setting the update channel and updating the product are two separate actions. Many of our enterprise customers have to manage customized environments and enforced customized policies. For example, sometimes in these environments, the client machines don't have access to the internet. Or sometimes the development teams want to tightly control exactly what version of the product their team uses. For these types of scenarios, the IT admins usually wind up in creating and maintaining a network layout of the Visual Studio product that they then make available for their client machines to install or update from. Well, with the new ability to configure where the client looks for updates, you can easily configure it to look for updates in a layout location that you make available. And since layouts are very popular with IT administrators, we thought it'd be helpful to make this layout changing functionality work for all visions of Visual Studio that the installer controls. In other words, this functionality will work down level for VS 2019 and VS 2017 too. Again, let me show you what I'm talking about. Going back to my example, I already showed you that my Visual Studio 2022 instance can get updates from one of three Microsoft hosted channels. Now it just so happens that my Visual Studio 29 instance was installed on this machine a while ago via a network layout. You can see here that the update channel is named Private Channel, and the package location is here on this network server that was used to install from a long time ago. Now, the update channel name for this layout install says Private Channel simply because we made the words Private Channel be the default channel name in situations like this, where an older product had already been installed long before this new 2022 installer arrived. So the last thing I'd like to show you in this section is the ability to somewhat customize what shows up in this dropdown. It's possible to configure what update options are available within your organization. For example, you can add additional network locations to serve as update channels, or you can hide Microsoft channels and prevent your clients from looking at Microsoft servers as a source for updates. Suppose I am an administrator in a very locked down environment, and I wanted to make both my 2022 instance and my 2019 instance get updates from new layouts that I just created based on security updates from Microsoft that came out last Patch Tuesday. Also, I don't really like the default name Private Channel in my 2019 instance, so I want to change that channel name too. Well, I can do all of this by configuring a few entries in this client's registry, which I'll do now. I have here this registry file that I'll import into the registry. Now I'll bring the update settings dialog up again, and you can see that I've added my layout. In this 2022 version, I have the current channel, and I have my new private layout channel too. In this 2019 version, I've renamed Private Channel to something that's more meaningful to my organization, and I've also added another layout channel here too. This particular configuration I demonstrated is just an example. We have a few other dials available to facilitate slightly different scenarios, so refer to the Visual Studio Administrator's Guide for additional details. I hope you can see and appreciate that configuring and managing updates is now a lot easier with Visual Studio 2022. Even though my demo illustrated how to change a channel through the UI in the installer, you can also get to this UI directly within the IDE by going to the Help menu and checking for updates. And most importantly, this functionality is accessible through the command line so that admins can manage this stuff programmatically. The third improvement I'd like to make you aware of is regarding layouts. As I mentioned earlier, a lot of enterprises use layouts to control which exact version of the product is used within their organization. As with most important things in life, one of the biggest costs of using layouts is dealing with the maintenance. Layout maintenance is absolutely necessary in order to keep both them and their clients updated and secure. With Visual Studio 2019 and below, there are a few, shall we say, hurdles with managing layouts. The process of updating layouts was sometimes rather difficult to either do or to get right. In some situations, the new layout folder would not be recognized, and in other situations, it was tricky to determine exactly what the layout would even be updated to. We've recently spent a lot of time and effort polishing up these scenarios, and with Visual Studio 2022, we've made it much easier for you to confidently update and maintain layouts. First of all, you can now reliably change the network location of a layout. In other words, if your client installed from a layout in one location, and you've recently created a layout in another location, you can easily configure your client to update from the new layout by using the Change Update Channel functionality that I just showed you. This is a pretty simple concept, and a lot of our customers just expected it to work. Well, it just didn't always work before, but I'm happy to say the scenario works now all of the time. Now, in order to change layout update locations, you just need to have the functionality that comes with this new and improved Visual Studio 2022 installer. So we're providing the ability for you to distribute this new installer in your older 2019 and 2017 layouts. Once the new installer gets installed on your client machines, then the clients will be able to switch to get updates from a new layout. The next set of layout improvements I want to call your attention to is with the bootstrappers. The bootstrapper is the file that's named something like vsenterprise.exe, and it's the thing that you double-click on to install Visual Studio. It basically has just enough information to kickstart the installation process. The bootstrapper can also be used to update a layout. In earlier versions of the product, if you wanted to update your layout to a very specific version of Visual Studio, you might have discovered this web page, which has links to all of our available bootstrappers. You may have clicked one of these links next to the exact version that you wanted, downloaded that bootstrapper, and use it to update your layout. A simple but immensely helpful improvement we've made to the bootstrapper is to reflect both the channel and the product version in the file's properties. Here, I have a 2022 bootstrapper. You can see that the file properties in the Details tab now tells you which version and channel it will install. This information helps you confirm that what you execute to update a layout is actually what you intend. This bootstrapper here is going to install the latest release that exists on the 17.0 LTSE channel and is going to configure the layout to use that channel. Another way we're making layout maintenance easier is by providing another location for you to acquire updates from. As you're presumably aware, earlier in 2021, we started shipping Visual Studio Administrator updates through the Microsoft Update channel. As part of distributing through Moo, we've been putting all of our administrator updates up on the Microsoft catalog too. So you can also update a layout by just downloading one of these update packages from the catalog and use that to update your layout. By keeping your layouts updated with the packages that you get here, you can have confidence that your layout will get updated to the exact same version of Visual Studio that we're promoting as current and secure. Again, for everything I've discussed here, read the Online Administrator's Guide for details on how to do all of this. Now, the final thing I would like to make you aware of is just how many benefits Visual Studio comes with and how easy it is for your users to access them. The vast majority of companies, when they purchase rights to use Visual Studio, do it by way of subscriptions. There are two main ways of distributing subscriptions to your users. The old school method involves distributing keys, which works in the sense that it allows your teams to use just the Visual Studio product. But there's so much more goodness that the subscription has to offer that the old key method won't unlock. Instead, if you took the additional step of assigning email addresses to subscriptions, then each person would have access to the additional benefits that the subscription offers, such as Azure credits, Pluralsight training, or access to all historical downloads that Microsoft produced. So we really encourage you to both assign their email addresses to subscriptions and to encourage your users to visit myvisualstudio.com either through the website or through the IDE to become aware of the other resources that are available to them. One way for an admin to assign email addresses is to go to the managevisualstudio.com portal and either assign names individually or upload a file that contains a bunch of names. We recently enabled another convenient way for admins to assign email addresses to subscriptions. You can now create an Azure Active Directory group, assign that to a subscription, and then simply add your users to this AAD group. At any rate, I hope you and your users are able to take advantage of all the extra value that your Visual Studio subscriptions entitle you to. Thank you very much for listening to this talk and learning about the changes we've made to Visual Studio to improve the IT admin experience. You can find additional details of everything I've discussed in the online documentation of the Visual Studio Administrator's Guide. We're in the process of planning for the next release of Visual Studio and would love to hear your feedback. We have a survey available where you, our partners, can leave your contact information along with details of your environment and any challenges that you're having. That way, we'll have a better understanding of your situation so that we can better design for it in the future. We've also enabled a special IT admin way for you to submit bug reports or problem to us. The initial submission is public, but we can make it more private if you'd like. Of course, you can always reach out to your account manager as well. Lastly, we put announcement on the VS blog, so read that periodically and search on the admin keyword to find the content that you might be most interested in. We're looking forward to continued partnership with IT admins in the years to come. Stay safe and happy adminning.